A blessed day and welcome. This morning we will be meditating from the book of Daniel, chapter 1 and verse 8. But Daniel resolved not to defile himself with the royal food and wine, and he asked the chief official for permission not to defile himself this way. If Daniel is known for anything at all, it's integrity. In spite of being taken captive into Babylon, he, together with his Jewish friends, refused the delicacies of the king and opted to honor the living God in spite of his circumstances. Daniel could have done whatever he pleased, after all he was young, with no elder or leader watching over him. Yet he chose to be disciplined and honor God, for he revered him above all. Though no one else was watching, Daniel knew God was, and that he would need to give an account someday. One time, many years ago, the king of Hungary found himself depressed and unhappy. He sent for his brother, a good-natured but rather indifferent prince. The king said to him, "I am a great sinner. I fear to meet God." But the prince only laughed at him. This didn't help the king's disposition in any way. Though he was a believer, the king had gotten a glimpse of his guilt for the way he'd been living lately, and he seriously wanted help. In those days, it was customary if the executioner sounded a trumpet before a man's door, at any hour, it was a signal that he was to be led to his execution. The king sent the executioner in the dead of the night to sound the fateful blast at his brother's door. The prince realized with horror what was happening. Quickly dressing, he stepped to the door and was seized by the executioner and dragged pale, trembling, into the king's presence. In an agony of terror, he fell on his knees before his brother and begged to know how he had offended him. "My brother," answered the king, "if the sight of a human executioner is so terrible to you, shall not I, having grievously offended God, fear to be brought before the judgment seat of Christ?" Precious ones, there's an important lesson to learn today, and that is that a person who lives by faith lives to please the Lord, whether anyone is watching or not. Such a person is always conscious of God's presence. No one has yet attained perfection, yet we must strive to live godly lives with the hope of facing the Master. We shall all surely meet the Lord one day. Therefore, let us live as though it was a moment away. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, help me to embrace the reality of seeing you soon and live each moment with godly fear. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Shalom. Maranatha.